We are talking today with Dr. Alexei Yablokov. Dr. Alexei Yablokov was the environmental advisor to Russian President Yeltsin and advisor to the Gorbachev administration. He is a counselor of the Russian Academy of Science and currently serves as Nuclear and Radiation Safety Program Chair for the International Socio-Ecological Union. He is also currently one of the leaders of the Russian environmental movement and the author of over 400 scientific papers and 22 books. And he is here today to talk about his latest book, Chernobyl, Consequences of the Catastrophe for People and Nature, a comprehensive presentation of all the available information concerning the health and environmental effects of the low-dose radioactive contaminants that were emitted from the Chernobyl nuclear power plant in 1986. So if you could begin, tell us, what was your motivation in writing this book, Chernobyl, Consequences of the Catastrophe for People and Nature?
When I was elected in the Soviet Parliament and was a deputy chair of Soviet Committee of Environment for Soviet Parliament, we have to discuss what the main problem, environmental problem, facing the Soviet Union in the end of his end of Gorbachev era, and we immediately locate. That the main problem is the radioactive pollution, originated from Chernobyl, originated from many other sources. It was mostly secret in Soviet time. Even Chernobyl was secret. It was my duty and my feeling is extremely important to expose this data, to find real fact about Chernobyl consequences. And it was start of my activity in this field. And after this, I collect a lot of data, because I visit not only Chernobyl places, I visit many other nuclear radioactive polluted places, and collect data, collect step by step what happened just 5 years ago. You mentioned that I published book, which last year it had been published in New York Academy of Science publisher, is Consequences of Chernobyl. Why happened it this book? Just because in 2005, World Health Organization and International Atomic Energy Commission published some review of Consequences of Chernobyl on the eve of 20 anniversary. Now we have 25, but that time it was 20 anniversary. And they declare that nothing serious. We overcome this problem. It will be only no more than 9,000 deaths from cancer during 80 years after Chernobyl, for Chernobyl generation, so-called. And maybe a couple of 100,000 additional illnesses, and nothing more. Time to forget Chernobyl. I was so furious. I was so unhappy that I decided to present my view, because I know that it's absolutely not true, because I know how big scale of people suffering, not only in Ukraine, where Chernobyl situated, Chernobyl nuclear power plant situated, but also in Belarus, in Russia, and other countries, by the way. So I try to intensively collect the data. And this book, which have been published last year in New York, is a result of my study. I call it meta-review. I review the reviews about 5,000 scientific papers, mostly published in Russia, mostly published in Ukrainian and Belarus. And this happened. And that happened.
So had no one ever gone through these other papers and looked at them before?
Никто не просматривал эти отчеты раньше до вас, и никто их не принимал во внимание.
Yeah. A lot of people try to collect such data and successfully collect data and published a lot of review, but
никто не, nobody paid attention, nobody paid attention.
Yes, you're right. Nobody paid enough attention, but also it was special company to calm this data. Why? It happened because from beginning I cannot understand why people's official, including official, so calm. Just now I can explain. It was, from my point of view, shameless agreement between with the World Health Organization and the International Atomic Agency Commission. It was signed in 1959. Under this agreement, under this official agreement, World Health Organization never will be published something against nuclear without consultation with nuclear agency. So it was so shameful. This is main reason why a lot of scientific papers do not accept it, do not widely distribute it. We have very interesting situation in Russia, in Belarus and Ukraine. We have state report about Chernobyl consequences. It partly accepts the data that much more dangerous that World Health Organization and the International Atomic Agency Commission pretend to be. But only partly, because it's a system of covering, even in the United States. In this book, which I mentioned, I exposed such a fact. Only after 8 years from Chernobyl catastrophe, it had been published here, not so secret, but concealed document about contaminated food. In one week after Chernobyl, here, United States Custom detect the not heavy pollution, but visible contaminated herring from Norway. Step by step, during several months, they collect data and locate contaminated cheese from Germany and Spain, contaminated fruit from Turkish, even chocolate from Switzerland have been contaminated by Chernobyl. At this several, it was hundred and hundred data about this. Hundred. I look at it. I was greatly surprised. Among these products, it was at least, I think, about 15 or something like this party. Group of food, which have been destroyed, even destroyed, because the heavy contaminated, radioactive contaminated. Nobody tell it to the public. Nobody. Only after special court case, this data have been released. So even in the United States. Till to now, we have a lot of... So it means that any government, not only United States, but not only Russian, any government do not so happy with contamination, with radioactive consequences. Such a strange system. Because just now, look what happened in Fukushima in Japan. Information going very little, at all information, no immediate danger, be safe, not so worry, no immediate danger, something like this. So
do you believe that's because of the influence that the nuclear power industry has worldwide?
Вы думаете, потому что такое влияние имеет ядерная промышленность во всем мире?
Is a part of explanation. Maybe the bulk of explanation. Yeah, I think I agree. This is because enormous influence from nuclear lobby. Mind, nuclear lobby. It's not only nuclear power plant. Nuclear lobby. It means a nuclear weaponry. It's the same. It's one lobby, because nuclear weaponry. Tightly connected with nuclear power plant. Tightly connected with nuclear power plant. Nuclear energy is the tail of nuclear weapon. It happened from beginning, but now situation is very interesting. Situation changed. If country like Iran or some other, там, Syria or Lebanon want to have nuclear bomb, they try to construct nuclear power plant. And each country which have his own nuclear power plant pass more than half away to the nuclear bomb. So it's enormous powerful nuclear lobby, enormous powerful, because it not only commercial interest, but it's also military interest. And I can say that all country which develop nuclear energy some way connected with nuclear weapons. Even Switzerland, even Sweden. So they have nuclear plan for construct nuclear bomb in the previous year. Japan, of course. Germany, of course. It's
I believe Germany just recently announced in the last couple of days that they were looking at eliminating nuclear power from their country.
Мне кажется, что Германия несколько дней тому назад объявила, что они будут eliminate.
The Angela Merkel, the German chancellor, have very wise, fast and wise
decision
after Fukushima. They order to stop activity for seven nuclear power old one. Every extremely old seven nuclear power plant, which old. I hope it will never open again. But now it is a very tight inspection. Situation very similar which you have here in the United States and we have in Russia also, because nuclear power plant have been constructed 40 years ago. 50 years ago, and they have its own lifespan. Lifespan about 35 years, 40 years, something like this. After this, it have to be demolished. It have to be stopped and demolished to the green lawn. It never happened. And in United States, in Russia, in Germany, in Japan, nuclear lobby начали продлевать.
Began to reopen the licenses.
Yeah. It happened, and look for Fukushima. Fukushima, lifespan of Fukushima ended before catastrophe. So it artificially conditioned, not artificially, как вот это я сказал, но не искусственно продлили.
They went on with the licenses,
licenses, delaying for next 10 years,
delaying the closure for 10 years, yeah.
For 10 years, for 15 years, it became, not only in Japan, not only, but it became extremely dangerous situation all over the globe, because aging of nuclear power plant, it put all of this fleet, nuclear fleet, near to catastrophe, like Fukushima. No, my prediction was in several months ago that we will have in this year, we will have something like Fukushima at several months before Fukushima, I based in this prediction on the level of safetiness, which going down now for all nuclear power plant. This is why I saw support the decision from Angela Merkel, German Chancellor, who stop immediately the continue to exploitate old nuclear power plant, which
are very dangerous, very dangerous, extremely dangerous.
All right, talk more about what effects you believe Chernobyl actually had. Maybe start on the people who worked directly on it to deal with that catastrophe.
The main discrepancy between my point of view and official point of view about consequences of Chernobyl based on the method of collection of fact. All official bodies based on the approach. If you, they compare illnesses or mortality with level of
radiation
exposure, so-called doses. But doses, it never possible to detect exactly, because it every time calculation, how much milk average person drink, how much water, contaminated water, average person drink, how many minutes or hours or day in contaminated area spent average person, and so on. It every time it's not so. It look like average temperature in hospital. So it's absolutely unreasonable, from my point, absolutely unreasonable. We conduct other approach. We take, we compare the territory heavy contaminated, because it's possible to detect by Geiger counter or other, what the level contamination on the land or air. And we compare the population health condition on this territory with other territory which situated nearby, but not have not such a radioactive level, considerably less contaminated in absolutely similar for all other characters. Population, economy, geographical, absolutely similar. Only differ from radiation level. It give us immediately visible differences. It was not my personal study. It was very active group statistics and biologists from St. Petersburg who compare six heavy polluted Russian districts, non-districts
areas.
Area, we called it oblast, provinces, no, like provinces, like American state. Six heavy contaminated with nearby six non-contaminated area. They have data, collect a lot of data, statistical data. They have possibility to compare for 15 years beginning from 1990 till to 2004. 15 years, that's such a period. It happened that during this period, the mortality in contaminated area, at not contaminated, differ for about 4%. 4% additional mortality on heavy contaminated territory. If you calculate in the number of the deaths, it look like about 60,000 additional deaths on this territory, on this heavy contaminated territory. No, step by step, it's possible to calculate more wide, similar territory in Ukraine and similar territory in Belarus, Belarusia. And it took that several hundred additional deaths for 15 years. Several hundred thousand additional deaths for 15 years. And this is the base for our calculation. As a result, we have such a data. For all globe, mind why it's important to think about all globe. In Russia, Belarus and Ukraine have only 33% of Chernobyl radiation. 33%. It means that 57% Chernobyl radiation dispersed in other territory. Where bulk of this in the Western and Central Europe. About 20% go away from Europe and struck United States, North Africa, and Asia. I think United States received about 2 or 3% of Chernobyl radiation. Chernobyl, it's huge amount. By the way, it's huge amount. And when we collect all this data and recalculate based on the very detailed study in Soviet, in Russia, in Soviet, former Soviet Union, it look like we have now about 1 million additional deaths. Not 9,000, like official World Health Organization told us, but about 1 million additional deaths. It's not only cancer. It's from heart attack, from brain, many reason. But it's our approach give us possibility to have a common picture. What is общую картину?
Yes, general picture.
General picture. So this result such 1 million additional deaths for 25 years or 24 years, something like this. And million and million additional illnesses, case of illnesses, mortality. Not mortality, but morbidity. Morbidity. So?
Would that also include the number of cancers that people would be picking up worldwide?
Это также включает и количество канцера, который получен.
We have in the book, I will show you, we have special chapter, because I'm not only author of the book, three author, one from Russia, me, and two from Belarus, some nuclear physics, very famous nuclear physics from Belarus. So we mentioned we have special chapter about cancer, and we have the data, calculate data for each country, for each European country, what additional number of cancer it can to be predict for each country. No, it's look like I do not remember the exact numbers, but about 300,000 something like this additional cancer deaths, because what is interesting, our prediction, our result quite comparable with two other sources. You have here in United States such a bright person like John Hoffman, John Goffman, he is once from San Francisco. He was a fantastic person. He was participate in physics. As a young person, he was a young member of the team who first time in history take the plutonium. It was part of the what called it nuclear project, nuclear bomb. But after this, in several 20 years or 30 years, he stopped his nuclear activity, received some medical education, and became one of the strongest person who act against nuclearization of the globe. Like Andrei Sakharov in my country, the same great physic who invite some new construction of nuclear bomb, hydrogen bomb, or something like this, but after this he turned away to protect human being from radiation. So we have a lot of John Hoffman calculate only cancer, calculate cancer for all of the globe based on data how many radionuclides released from Chernobyl, and he found that it was about half million people, 500,000 people who will be death because cancer from Chernobyl cancer. About five. So the other calculation based on published some Canadian epidemiologist, wonderful woman, very interesting, Rosalie Bertel. Rosalie Bertel. She published twice some calculation, and she calculated that it have to be. They could also based on amount of radioactivity which exploded with released from Chernobyl. She makes such a data that about 2 million additional deaths, 1.8 something like this million additional deaths from forever from Chernobyl fallout from many generation. So it very very close to our estimation. We count about 1 million during 20 to 25 years, something like this, and it's look like all of this coincident with John Hoffman calculation, with Rosalie Bertel calculation, give me more assurance that we are going the right way. Not several thousand, but at least several hundred thousand additional deaths.
I believe John Goffman thought that low-level nuclear radiation and exposure was more dangerous than high-level because the high-level at least destroys the cells, where the low-level just mutates the cells. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, you are right. You're a very good informed person. I am glad. Yeah, it's really one of the scientific knowledge which we catch after Chernobyl, it is the low-level radiation, which continue every day, much more dangerous than the high-level radiation which struck you one day or 1 minute. Much more dangerous. But the mechanism of this impact not so clear till to now. It need a lot of money, a lot of study to catch some molecular or genetical mechanism why it happened. General explanation which based on John Goffman investigation and Елена Бурлакова in my country, great person also who study molecular consequences of Chernobyl, any low level radiation, it look like our adaptive system in our organ do not locate the small dose of radiation and do not act against them. So such a trick.
Do you believe, based on what we already know about what has happened in Japan, that we're looking at something that's less equal to or worse than what happened at Chernobyl?
By amount of radioactivity, Fukushima, of course, less scale catastrophe than Chernobyl, but it's not the end. In some other possibility, maybe even more worse, because Fukushima have one of reactor Fukushima have MOX fuel, plutonium uranium fuel. It never happened before that something wrong happened with MOX fuel. General understanding that it will be much more dangerous than simple uranium fuel because a lot of plutonium. Also, it never happened before that simultaneously the several nuclear reactor was going under out of control. It never happened before. It nobody knows what the result of this multi-nuclear catastrophe. It multi-nuclear catastrophe. It never happened before that something happened, happened with spent nuclear fuel pond, which situated near every nuclear power plant. My friend, I am personally, and a lot of my friend, many years, at least 10 years before, pointed, this is the pool with spent nuclear fuel, maybe even more dangerous than nuclear power plant, because they contain much more radiation than inside reactor. Because it's many
reactors.
Reactor fuel they have in this storage. This is also so and the last, but maybe it's the most important thing, heavy populated area. Heavy populated area. In Chernobyl, it happened, it rural area, and 100 kilometers around of Chernobyl, it was only small city, small villages, no, look like general, maybe 10 million people inhabited near to Chernobyl territory. In Fukushima, we have maybe 40 million people nearby Fukushima. Even small, even we will have small radioactivity. The result of this small radioactivity impact may be worse than in Chernobyl. Friend of mine, professor, English professor Chris Busby, calculated 4 days ago that amount of radioactivity, no, nobody knows exactly, but look like it possible to predict how much radioactivity, as I remember, French physics predict that it may be released five days ago, about 1.5 million Curie from Fukushima. All amount of radioactivity from Chernobyl is 50 million Curie. In Fukushima, less than 2 million Curie. It's enormous radioactivity, but 20 or 30 times less than in Chernobyl. But the population, heavy populated area, heavy populated area. It's physical law. If much people going under radiation, struck the radiation, it will be, of course, it will be much worse result. I come back to Chris Busby calculation. He mentioned 4 days ago that by his estimation, it had been at least 120,000 additional cancer deaths from Fukushima.
You've been working on this issue for a long time. If you were put in charge of a worldwide program for nuclear power and or nuclear weapons, what would you do?
Good question. Oh, first of all, it was immediately shut down old nuclear power plant, immediately, all over the globe, because it never the old car will be running like, driving like new one. So it's immediate dangers, it's the old nuclear power plant, aging nuclear power plant. You have to stop it. Next, my step. I think it needs to concentrate more money, more attention, more scientific power to develop new source of energy, because nuclear energy unacceptable, dangerous. Look, the typical answer for my nuclear friends, so-called coal industry have a result more deaths than coal power plant, have some about 10,000 additional deaths a year, and nuclear power plant have several deaths. Yeah, but it's not true, because happened Chernobyl, happened Fukushima, happened some other nuclear catastrophe, and the death toll growing 1,000 times. So it also it impossible if some people death because chemical pollution from coal power plant, it will be end. But if some because the reason for death from coal power plant is a heavy polluted air, heavy chemical pollution, not radiation. Radiation, yes, it also radiation. Some coal have some radiation, but it's natural radiation, not so dangerous like radiation going from nuclear reactors. But nuclear reactor creates some consequences that negative consequences will be passing through generation. Broken chromosome and some other, it's going through degeneration. Even you have now, for example, 10 deaths and thousands of illnesses, it will be going to next generation, Just now, I look today report from Ukrainian parliament. They discuss the problem with liquidator. Liquidator is the person who participated in, like Fukushima nuclear samurai. We have similar, but much more, people, about 800,000 people liquidator in Chernobyl. In Fukushima, we have maybe 1,000. So, children of liquidator have enormous level of genetic damage. Children of liquidator. So it's
all right. Well, with that, we are unfortunately out of time. I want to thank you very much for coming and spending time with us today.
Thank you very much.